Hey guys, good morning, good afternoon, and good evening. I'm here again. My name is Promise Bell from Promas Recording Studios. I'm here with a tutorial on how to master a gospel song, and also you can apply this to any kind, any genre of song you are currently working on. And I will advise you to stick from beginning to the end of this video to gain this knowledge. Without wasting your time and your data, let's jump right into it. So I have a project here. Our title, Ogenerukeve, is an Urhobo song by artist Desmond. To start with, number one, there is no good mastering without a good mix. It simply means if your mix is bad, there is nothing that can be done about the mastering. Number two, do not apply excessive weight in your mix. Who mix and mix it very heavy. Mastering is about checkmating volumes, weight, and surrounding and many of those stuffs. Regulate your volume. There's a software called MV. MV. Let me put it for you so you can see. MV. This software will help you checkmate your volume level. You are supposed to be mixing below 6 dB, at most 6 dB. So after producing the entire song, you go to your master track and insert this MV. So you play the song, after playing the song, you adjust it down, you can see. So it's around minus 7, minus 6. Are you seeing it? My current meter level. So when you are doing your mix, make sure all those stuffs are done. When those stuffs are done, then you cannot get right into the mastering stage. So the first thing I have here is my SSL compressor stereo. So as you can see, my threshold is around 2.9. My makeup is around 11.6. Then my attack is around 1 ms. And for me, it's even too much because the song is a fast song. These are the things you need to know. If you are mastering a fast song where especially the kick is coming too frequent, you have to regulate your attack. So my attack will be around 1 ms. Probably I can leave it at 3. That's fine. My mix should be at 100% and my release should be at 1, like I said before, because the song is a fast song. Some people would rather put it on auto. No. I prefer to control my mix. Then my ratio is around 10. Then my rate is around 7. Play the song and you check your reduction meter. As you can see, it's not so much. But if you feel that's not enough, you just need to recontrol your ratio. You can take it to 4. As you can see, it's beating, is reducing more. But this is a mastering stage. You're not supposed to be overcutting out. So I'll leave it at 10. The next thing we have is our X1 image stereo enhancer. So this is from Waves. This will help you expand the mix a bit and also help to push a bit away from the ear level. So you just need to control yours. And I recommend an headphone when you are working with this image stereo enhancer. So the third thing I have here is my LLU Ultra Stereo from Waves also. This is another maximizer on its own. It's a maximizer, a very powerful maximizer. So you can see my threshold is around minus 3.4 and my art ceiling is on 0. So what I will do next, I will play the song and check the art 10 reduction level. You can see that is not enough, so it means I still have some room to increase the volume. So as it's playing, be looking at this portion, look at this portion and check the reduction level. So it shouldn't be more than 2, at most 3. So right now it's around 2 minus 2.1, which is fine by me, but sometimes I love to drive it all the way to minus 3. Fantastic, this is good. So at minus 8.4, I got a reduction of minus 2. So next is our sibilance. This will help to remove any form of clipping. This will cut any form of clipping. So I'll play the song. I feel this is good, but I would love to reduce it a bit to 15. Yeah, so this is good at minus 15.5 and our detection is good at 40. So next The next is NLS channel stereo. This helps to spike your mix. You don't need to use this too much. So I'll set my VGA on 1. Then also my drive should be around 1.2. The highest 1.2. My output should remain the same. I'm seeing a bit of overdrive at the syncopated part of the song. Listen again. So what I just needed to drop the output a bit. So next is my L3 Ultra from Waves also. So at this point, I will reduce this one a bit. You can see this is around -5, which is too much. That was why that meter was showing that clipping red region. So when you are done, export it on your phone first. Do your testing first. Don't send a job to a client for the client to help you test it. That is very unprofessional. Test your song. You should know how your device sounds by now. You should know the depth of your speakers. You should also understand your space. So what I do normally is after mastering the song, I will put it on my smaller speakers. I play there, put it on my three-way speakers, I'll play it on my two-way speakers and see that it's okay. After that, I will export it into my phone and play it. I use an Oppo phone which has more depth. So if I can feel my kick and my bass on the phone speaker, I know that okay, this mix is very good to go. So this cut is way too much, so we'll reduce it a bit. Let's go to -4.0. So we're having between -3.0 to -3.4, which is still too much. Let me reduce it a bit. Alright, so we have -2.7, which is very, very good. So the next on my list is my U-Link loudness meter. This is to check my loudness meter. And this part is usually very controversial. Some people say your LUFS should be around highest -11. Search for the maximum loudness for all your streaming platforms. Then you cannot maximize your mastering to a level whereby it can fit into all sections. So let's play it and check. Okay, you can see it's running between -6 to -7.7. Oh, that's fine. The last year is the same as this loudness meter, just to double check what I already have here and what is here. So my long term here is showing between -8 and my range, my LU is around 10. Alright, so that is how I do my master. So the last thing I will check here is my master volume. I will make sure it's not hitting yellow, not even red. What I will advise, the strongest point of the song, we are doing a gospel song, so there are some portions where syncopation will come in, that becomes more stronger than the other parts that are a bit quiet. Move the cursor to your chorus point where you have a fuller or you have more response. We have the lead vocal, you have the backup, you have the instrument playing at the same time. That is where you should play around. Then the last thing, what you should do now is to not check your weight level, your eye level and your mid level. Those three things contribute to the entire mastering process. So what I recommend for people is, you can use MB, Pro MB by FabFitter. So I play the song and examine the different levels at which they are playing. So I can see at this point, is a bit too much at this point, which is your high mid. You can solo at any point, so I'll click solo and play that part. Good. So I will just a bit recompress this part. So let's edit it. I also took the output down a bit. So the next part is this session. So solo this session. Okay. All right. right. You can see it. So I will come to this last part, solo it, then very good. So at this point I am good to go. So what I'll do at this point is my speaker testing, that's all, and I am good to go. Thank you so much for watching. Please, if you are confused at any point or you need some of these softwares, please you can drop request on the comment section and I will send you the link to some of this software that I have just used. My name remains Promise Bill, Promise Records. Please, if this tutorial has been helpful, please click the subscribe button by encouraging us to continue on more videos. God bless you. I will see you around. Thank you.